Hi, I'm Jon Burlingame. I write about film music for Variety, and we are here in the studio of Ludwig Göransson talking about his Oscar-nominated score for Black Panther. So, Ludwig, how did you get involved with the Black Panther film?
Thanks to the director, Ryan Coogler. We've been friends since 12 years ago. He was one of my first American friends that I met when I moved out here. I went to USC, and he was also part of the film program at USC, and I was into the film music program. And we met by chance at a party, and he just started talking to me about Swedish artists, like Lykkeli and Little Dragon, and all these kind of indie Swedish artists. And I was like, how do you know about all these Swedish music artists? And then we started talking about film, and we became friends. And a couple of months later, he called me and asked me if I wanted to score his 508, a short film, 5-minute short film called Locks. And I did, and as soon as I saw it, you know, I was like, oh my God, I could tell that there was something special about this guy.
So then when you guys both left school, he continued to call you?
Yeah, right as we were still friends, so we kept up to date with each other, what was going on. He had 3 more years in school after I graduated, and right after he graduated, he did a movie called Fruitvale Station, right out of school. And he asked me if I wanted to score it, and of course, I scored it, and it went to Sundance Film Festival. It won all the big award. Everything kind of changed. Like, we were there together, and like, no one kind of knew about Ryan Coogler or about this movie. And then like, all of a sudden, like, everything just kind of changed over that week. And it was so incredible to be there and experience that together. And right after that, he went on to do Creed, which is a part of the Rocky universe,
right.
A boxing movie. And you know, that was kind of my first bigger budget studio film at the time, and he brought me along with him, and we worked on that, and then Black Panther came right afterwards.
So when he talked to you about Black Panther, did Ryan have ideas about what should be done musically, or did he kind of leave it up to you?
I mean, first thing he did was send me the script, so I know, I know that he was working on it, and one day I got the script from him. He asked me to read it, and I read the script, and I told him, you know, I was extremely excited and moved by the script, and you know, I called him and I said, hey man, like I'd love to do it, but like the only way I could score this movie is to go to Africa and learn and study music.
That sounds like a pretty sort of ambitious goal right from the outset. You had to go to Africa? Why?
I read the script, and I could tell that the only way I could do it was to use and implement traditional African music into the score. And to do that in the right way, I need to understand what it is, and need to understand and study that type of music. And it's something that spoke to me was Western African music, especially because of the drums that they use there. Like the sabar drums, then the energy that they have really spoke to me in a kind of a cinematic way. So me and my girlfriend, we're married and a wife, we bought 2 tickets to Senegal, and we didn't really know what else to do. I mean, and then I got a number to Baaba Maal.
Sare, 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 Nyamrama, Sare.
So Baaba Maal is a world famous Senegalese musician, and he's extremely famous in Africa, but also he tours all over the world and does big concerts. And I found out about him through a mutual friend of mine from Sweden that I produced an album with him and Mumford & Son. And so I got Baaba Maal's number. I called him a week before we were going to Senegal, and I was like, "Hey, like, do you have time to meet up in Senegal or just record something or just hang out?" And he was like, "Yeah, just come out. You guys can join me on tour. Like, I'm gonna go on a week-long tour. You just come with me, and we'll talk."
So, talk a little bit about your musical experiences there and what you felt you were able to take away that might be applicable to Black Panther.
We ended up spending a week traveling and touring with Baaba Maal and meeting all of these incredible musicians in all these different villages and talking to his band and talking to his closest friends. And I got to meet a talking drum player. His name was Masamba Diop, and he played talking drum in Baaba Maal's band. A talking drum is a percussion instrument. It's a drum that you put under your shoulder, and you squeeze it, and it changes pitch. So it's more kind of, I think it's more similar to a voice than a drum, because you can play with it and squeeze it, and it's like it hits different pitches. So if you play a special rhythm in a different pitch, it almost sounds like you're talking. So you can send messages to each other. You can say different words.
So what else did you find or discover that you thought might be useful?
Another instrument that we saw being played a lot was the kora, which is an African harp. And you hold it with your hands like that, and it's made of fishing lines. And you play it with both your hands, kind of like a harp.
Were there any sort of flute or vocal sounds that maybe you found interesting?
I came across this incredible musician. His name is Amadou, and he played the Fula flute, which I've never heard that sound before. When he came to the studio and I started recording with him, he started playing and like screaming in the flute and using his voice and I never heard that kind of type of sound before.
Oh, let's record. We have the with these strings, mm-hmm. So let's start really mysterious and little mysterious and careful and mysterious, and then go up in dynamic, okay. Wow. And go crazy.
Then it commence to look mysterious,
Killmonger.
One of the things that I think is terribly impressive about the score is there's this pretty substantial vocal element really kind of throughout the score. Sometimes we're hearing people singing things, and sometimes it's sort of more standard sort of in the background. When we hear people singing, are there lyrics? Are we hearing specific words or phrases? Or
yeah, there is one theme where it's just like chanting. It's like choo-choo-choo-choo, and that's a couple of the singers in Senegal that are doing this sound. And that kind of became the Dora Milaje theme, because it has this high, very kind of aggressive energy to it.
Black Panther turns out to be the year's most successful movie commercially. How did you feel about that?
I mean, extremely proud. I had no idea it was going to be talked about that much. It's going to have that big impact in the whole world. You know, it really reached out to every part of the world. And just seeing like the joy and the people got out of that and having had a little small part of that, I was extremely proud of it.
And it's amazing that it's sort of become a kind of cultural issue for people. People are talking about it, people are not just going to the movie, but it's actually sort of entered the cultural conversation now.
Yeah, it's, I've never been a part of a project like that before. And to, you know, to hopefully inspire a lot of young people, like there's a lot of people that never, a lot of younger black kids that never had a role model like this to see up to, and it's taking a long time for this to happen, and hopefully now there will be a lot of more movies like this coming out.
One of the other aspects of your career is that you're part of Childish Gambino.
My goodness, and the Grammy goes too. This is America, Childish Gambino!
Donald Glover and Ludwig Göransson.
Yes, Childish!
Engineers, Derek Nixbyali Ali, Mike Bozzi, Riley Mackin, and Sean Singh.
How do you balance writing for movies and also being a part of a major sort of presence on the pop and rock scene?
It's tough. It's tough because when you work on movies, like you don't really have any time to do anything else, but I think it's worked out really well for me because Donald Glover also has a kind of a similar schedule. He does so many different things. I mean, he's, you know, acting, directing, writing, music. So I think somehow, like, our schedules have, fortunate enough for me, like, our schedules have lined up with each other. I also really love producing and working with artists because when I write film scores, I'm just all by myself in the studio, the sitting like this, and it's dark, and I'm like growing, I don't know, start to look like a werewolf. But when I can come out and work, collaborate with artists, you know, that have completely different backgrounds, work with completely different music than what I normally do, that's when I learn new stuff.
And you're part of a band again.
And I'm part of a band again, yeah.
Great. Well, thank you for being with us today.
Well, thanks for having me.